I couldn't bring Manny to my home, that was for sure. I already had the basis of a false identity, which I'd started to build some years ago, just in case. I'd used the old Frederick Forsyth Day of the Jackal trick to obtain a passport, and taken it from there. I was aware of that idiot who faked his own death in a canoeing accident, and had successfully done the same thing. It seemed crazy that the scam had still worked, more than 40 years after Forsyth taught us all how to do it. But, knowing that it had worked so much more recently for Canoe Man, I decided to give it a go. It worked for me, too, and hadn't proved too difficult either. I'd homed in on a male who died as a child, but would have been about my age had he lived, and visited the National Records Office to gain the necessary papers, starting with a birth certificate. It was easy enough to follow through the required steps to acquire a passport, set up a bank account, and so on. That gave me the debit card, which I used to pay for my online dating activities, and anything else which necessitated plastic rather than cash. I'd opted for internet banking, of course, so all correspondence with my bank was online. Even acquiring a driving license hadn't been difficult. I just had to apply for a provisional and take a test. I was a good driver and sailed through it. I scanned the internet for affordable rental properties in Bristol. Most of what was on offer was out of my budget, and I was looking for a private rental, a property being advertised directly by the landlord. I wasn't sure that my false identity would stand up to the scrutiny of a bona fide estate agent. Eventually, I found a furnished, two-bedroomed flat, albeit in an area where I would not normally choose to live, which seemed suitable and was being advertised by a private individual. Apart from anything else, someone who wanted to avoid estate agents' fees was more likely to bend the rules. I arranged to meet the landlord at the property the same evening. It wasn't much.